They are the police officers tasked with protecting our harbour, waterways and ports. Today, 10 Marine Area Command crew have been recognised for their bravery in carrying out one of the most dangerous sea rescues in police history.
Waving from the deck of a police patrol boat, sailors John McAnally and Keith Turner, weary but relieved as they sail into Sydney Harbour. The men had to be rescued after their yacht hit bad weather, leaving them stranded in the middle of the Tasman Sea.
We had no electrical power, we couldn't start the motor, we couldn't steer the yacht, so we still had the mainsail, so we were basically dead.
With the yacht taking on water, they activated their distress beacon, triggering a maritime emergency. Marine Area Command officers boarding the Nemesis, the largest police vessel in the Southern Hemisphere, setting off on a 70-hour mission to rescue them.
It was actually the longest rescue undertaken by any Australian police force. It was a distance of about 595 nautical miles from Sydney. It's about 1,100 kilometres.
Nine News was invited on board to get a taste of the conditions the crew faced that day.
We knew they were constantly, slowly on the move, drifting with the wind. We just basically aimed as best we could towards their keeping their position on the monitor and our vessel going straight for them.
We're in 2 to 3 metre waves at the moment, so you can only imagine how difficult it must have been for the crew to reach the men stranded in 6 to 8 metre swell.
We couldn't actually see Nemesis. It was a 100-foot boat, but it was so rough and so dark because it arrived in the middle of the night.
The 10 police officers who carried out the daring rescue have now been recognised, each receiving an Australian Search and Rescue Award at a ceremony in Tasmania last night.
That's what you sign up for when you come to the water police. That's just the nature of the job. Yeah, it's really good to get a good result on this occasion.
It felt like we'd won lotto.
In Balmain, Kate Creedon, Nine News.